Hello everyone, this is Rachna and I'm here with one of the most interesting topics, something that I love watching myself, and that is wildlife. So I'm going to take you out on a tour to wildlife sanctuaries and national parks. So let's get started. So apart from whatever you have gone through about the Masai Mara's Serengeti in your book, let me tell you a little bit more about it. This is the Serengeti ecosystem, which is a geographical region in Africa, and it spans across the northern Tanzania. Now, this area is protected within the region, and it includes approximately 30,000 kilometers of land. And of course, it does have the Serengeti National Park as well in it. And it has several other game reserves and whatnot. And the interesting thing is that it is home to a whole lot of animals, you know, a whole huge wildlife. You know, children, you find the weirdest of animals and some of the most well-known animals here in Serengeti. Of course, you'll find giraffes, you'll find the wildebeest, you'll find, lions and whatnot over here. But yeah, it is an enormous place, a beautiful place, and children, this is one place where the safari is most well known throughout the world. Now here I have a little bit more information for you about this place, Serengeti. Children, I would definitely request you all that as and when you can, definitely go through Nat Geo Wild and you'll find more about it, right? This is about the great migration that happens in this Serengeti. Okay, now children, this migration is supposed to be the world's biggest migration ever of its kind. And what happens in this? It is a journey of the key players in the great migration, that is roughly around 2 million wildebeest. They start in the south of the Serengeti with the birth of 500,000 calves between January and March. Okay, is the favorite season for many of the seasoned Serengeti guides, you know, the people who guide us through. And in this picture you'll see that, of course, you know, there are animals who are there in Serengeti, but on one side you find the wildebeest. This is a small glimpse of what actually happens in this migration. You know, children, it actually coincides with the greening of the pastures over there in Serengeti. Okay, and it is to find food, etc., that close to 2 million wildebeest, they actually migrate. Right? Wow, now what do we have here? We have Jim Corbett National Park. I'm sure you people know how this national park got its name. And to be sure of again, and to let you know again, that it is located in Uttarakhand state in India, and it's in Ramnagar actually. So what do we know, what do we have about this Jim Corbett National Park? Well, it is a forested wildlife sanctuary. It's rich in flora and fauna. It's known for its Bengal tigers. Of course, you do have other animals as well, like you have, your elephants and so on and so forth. There are many, many monkeys, various kind of monkeys which you find over there. You'll find peacocks and a whole lot of other animals, you know, like leopards and hundreds of species of birds. Okay. And of course, the lion, the tigers, leopards, elephants, they roam the Dhikala zone on the banks of Ram Ganga reservoir. Okay, so this is a little more about the Corbett National Park. Wow, look at this lion, the way it's looking at you. And I'm very, very sure that just at the, with a glimpse of this lion, you know what we are coming to next, isn't it? This is the Gir National Park, or let's say the Gir Forest National Park, which is a wildlife sanctuary in Gujarat, Western India. It was established to protect the Asiatic lions who frequent the fenced off Devalia Safari Park, along with leopards and antelopes, of course, from the Giri jungle. So we do have a whole lot of safaris over here. And actually, you see, children, be it the Masai Mara Serengeti or the Corbett National Park or the Giri Forest National Park, you have a whole lot of safaris happening over here. Okay. And outside the fenced area of this Giri jungle trail, it traverses through deciduous forest and is home to wildlife including vultures and pythons. Okay, the Kamleshwar Dam has marsh crocodiles and birds over here. You have, you know, all these pelicans and all right here. It's in an area of around 1,412 kilometers. Okay. So now, next we have is the Yellowstone National Park. Now, children, Yellowstone National Park is a nearly 3,500 square mile wilderness recreation area atop a volcanic hotspot. Okay. Mostly in Wyoming, the park spreads into parts of Montana and Idaho too. Okay, now Yellowstone features dramatic canyons, alpine rivers, lush forests, hot springs, and gushing geysers. It includes the most famous Old Faithful. Yes, so it is, it includes its most famous Old Faithful geyser as well. And it is home to hundreds of animal species, including bears, wolves, bisons, elk, antelopes, etc. Now, children, why is it that the Yellowstone National Park is so very, very famous? You see this picture, this is of a geyser. All right, and Yellowstone, it sits on top of a dormant volcano. In the beginning, I just told you that there is a it sits over a volcano, atop a volcano. Okay, so it sits on top of a dormant volcano and it has more geysers and hot springs than any other place on earth. All right. So this is why it is more popular and recognized area, and also known to be the one of the most possessing one of the most natural wonders in United States, or for that matter any other place on earth. Well, now we have Ghana Bird Sanctuary, okay, or we can even call it as Kyoladio Ghana National Park, or if you remember, it was also known as Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary. Okay, so formerly it was called as Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary. Children, let us understand that it is recognized as one of the world's most important bird breeding and feeding areas. Okay, it is, as you have already come to know in your book, that it is, you know, about the Siberian cranes. And like them, there are many other beautiful migratory birds which come over here. You know, so it houses almost 200 species of birds. So you can well understand how huge and how important this particular bird sanctuary is. And again, you have a lot of safaris over here. So don't they look so beautiful, these migratory birds? Isn't it? I mean, just come to think of them. Think of it, you know, the way they just fly off and from one place to another. It's amazing, isn't it? Where on earth is Siberia and where on earth is India? And especially Ghana Bird Sanctuary. Now, next on the list you have Barbour Span Bird Sanctuary. Okay, now Barbour Span Bird Sanctuary is a huge 2000 hectare body of water located between Delairvale and Sanishof. The reserve is a pioneer in ornithological research. Okay, so this bird life of South Africa has declared it as an important national breeding site. Okay, so basically, like you already have it in your book, that there are over 350 bird species, which of course include the pelicans and flamingos, Aterian heron, crane, and a whole lot of others. Okay, well, towards the end we have Sundarban National Park. I'm sure everybody knows where it is. Of course, it is in India. And you know, children, this is basically a mangrove area. It forms a delta. And how does it form the delta? Because of the confluence of the Ganges, Brahmaputra and Meghna rivers in the Bay of Bengal. So just looking at this beast, you can well understand that the kind of delta it must be forming, and the mangrove, see the surrounding, look at the surrounding where this beast is sitting. You know, you can very well understand the kind of dangerous place it really must be, because of the mangroves, of course, and because of the water. You definitely have a whole lot of animals here. You know, it spans right from the Hooghly River in the India state of West Bengal to the Baleshwar River in Bangladesh. All right. And of course, it is home to a whole lot of reptiles, you know, apart the crocodiles or the Olive Ridley turtles as well. You even have them. And you cannot forget our Royal Bengal Tiger. So, this is what it is. Well, with this, we come to the end of wildlife tour. I know you don't see a wildlife dog sitting here, but yeah, I just want you all to know that thank you for watching, and do save the animals. As much as you can save them, please do save them. Help others in saving. If you can't do it yourself, at least help the others in saving them. They're very, very important part of our earth.